start off our group, let's go around and introduce ourselves with our name, what grade we're in, and if you know anyone in group. Would you like to start?
Sure. My name is Haley. I'm in fourth grade, and I know Nikki because she's in my class.
Oh, thank you, Haley. Mm-hmm.
Hi, I'm Nikki. I'm also in fourth grade, and I know Haley because she's in my class.
Oh. I'm Emma, and I'm in fifth grade, and none of my classmates are here, and I don't know anybody.
Yeah, I'm Ashley. I'm also in fifth grade, and I don't really know anybody either. Mm.
Okay. It's nice to meet all of you. I'm Miss B, and I'll be your group leader. So we're going to move on, and we're going to use M&Ms for an activity. So I'm going to pass you all M&Ms.
Ooh.
Thank
you. Mm-hmm.
Here you go.
Can we open them?
You can open them.
Mm-hmm. Can we eat them?
Not yet. Don't eat them yet. So, as you're opening your M&Ms, you'll see on the board some different colors that you might see. And for every color of M&M you have, say, I just have one green, so I might pick green. And for green, it says, what is your favorite color? So whenever you feel like you want to share, why don't you speak up and pull out your M&M, see that it's green, and tell us what your favorite color would be. Who wants to go first?
I have a green M&M.
Okay.
So I tell you my favorite color?
Yeah. What is your favorite color?
My favorite color is blue.
Mm. Is anyone else's favorite color blue? Mm. Well, my favorite color is blue.
Mm-hmm.
Who's next?
I can go. Mm-hmm. My favorite color is pink.
Okay.
Do I do a green one or do I do whatever color I want?
Whatever color you want.
I have a red, and that's also my favorite color. And this summer, I went to the Grand Canyon with my grandparents.
Mm. That's fun.
It was so fun.
You went with your grandparents?
Yeah, we went on a bus tour.
Wow.
Of all the canyons, but the Grand one was the best.
Mm-hmm. I bet.
I also have a green one, and my favorite color is purple, like my hair.
Yeah.
That was pretty.
Mm-hmm. Would anyone else like to go again?
I have a blue one.
Okay.
And I'm afraid of spiders.
Mm-hmm.
They're gross.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I also have a blue one, and I don't like cockroaches.
Oh! I see we have a blue theme going on.
Yep.
Would you like to share what you're scared of?
I have a blue one also. I have a few blue ones, but I'm afraid of natural disaster like hurricanes and earthquakes.
Mm-hmm. I'm afraid of snakes.
Okay.
We have a lot of them around my house now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we have a fear of a lot of like nasty critters and natural disasters. Good. Well, next I would like everyone to answer the last question. What do you hope to get out of this group? Or why are you here today?
I think I would just like to learn how to make more friends, because I don't really have any friends, like good friends anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So.
You want to know how to make good friends?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel like being here and all together, that'll be able to help you?
I think so. Maybe we can become friends. And I think it would be cool to make friends with fifth graders.
Yeah,
so.
Definitely. She's looking up to you guys.
Mm-hmm. I guess I want to be able to learn to talk to people because people scare me.
Mm.
Like, fifth graders are terrifying.
Yeah, that is terrifying.
And then some people in my class are just very judgy, and I'm scared of them.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be able to express my emotions to my friends so that they don't get upset when I get angry or sad, because sometimes I have a really hard time explaining myself, and so that makes it really hard to make friends.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Do you have a hard time explaining yourself?
Yeah, like, when you have, like, all of these feelings on the inside, and, like, I want to be able to, like, explain to them how I feel because they just walk away and think that I'm upset.
Okay. Thank you. I'm sorry, Ashley. Go ahead.
No, you're okay. I think I just want to learn how to talk to my friends when I think they're not being very nice or they're talking behind your back about something. No, I don't want to be mean and confront them, but also they're hurting my feelings.
Mm-hmm. So it sounds like there's a lot of real emotions going on for everyone, that we definitely feel like we're having a hard time making friends, and we also want to improve on associating with our classmates. So what do you think about similarities and differences between your answers? Anybody? Do you see some similarities or differences?
They were all about friends. Like, we all had problems with friends.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Friends are really hard.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So now that we kind of answered about what we hope to be here, what we hope to happen here, let's move into what we hope will happen here in terms of, like, rules and expectations. So I just wanted to open the floor and hear from you on what you expect here and any rules that you'd like to set for the group.
I think it'd be good if everybody respected each other.
Mm-hmm.
That's a big thing with friends. They don't always respect you or nice to you.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to see everyone be respectful to each other, something that you may not usually see with other peers?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I think we should be kind to each other. I think that's important.
Okay. Being kind.
Yeah.
Being respectful.
Mm-hmm. I don't want to be judged in the group for things I've said or how I act sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Could you explain that a little bit more?
Just like if I'm like, oh, like I said something that I think was stupid, and then I don't want people to be like, oh yeah, that was really stupid of you.
Right.
Or like look down on me because I asked a stupid question in group or something like that.
Mm-hmm. Good. Being kind and being respectful without being judged.
I don't want you guys to share my secrets with other people.
Mm-hmm.
If I tell you something.
Yeah, like other kids in school.
So you want what you share to stay in this group is what you're kind of saying? You don't want it to leave this group?
Yeah, because if I feel like you guys are going to tell other people, then I'm probably not going to tell you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, you said you agree.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Good. Are there any kind of expectations that anyone else is still thinking of before we move on? Well, you guys mentioned a lot of great expectations. One of them was being respectful and being kind, not being judgmental, and also not sharing any secrets. So not sharing secrets is really important. Another way we classify that is confidentiality, which means that, just like you said, what we're saying is not going to leave this room. So that is definitely one of the expectations of the group. Another one that we did not go over yet is attendance and being on time. So most of the time you guys will be here in school and I'll be able to pull you away for group, but just remember that you'll be going to group that day and you may want to just be aware of that, okay? Yeah, so those are some great expectations and I may be forgetting some, but we'll be able to figure out how group is going and assess that. So we're gonna move on to our next activity and it'll kind of be the main part of group. So as long as we're establishing rules and getting to know each other, I wanna talk a little bit more about what trust means to you guys. Kind of like Emma was saying, trusting each other with our secrets. So let's talk about what trust means.
This means like, sorry, you can go ahead.
I was just gonna say that
like kind of what Emma was saying, like, if I trust you, it's because I know you won't tell anybody what I say. And then also, if you trust me, it's because you know that I won't tell anyone what you say.
So it's between the person who shares and everybody who is listening.
I believe you. Like, when you promise something, I believe that you're telling the truth. I believe that you're going to do what you said. I don't believe everybody.
I think, like, feeling comfortable telling, like, speaking up about, like, our experiences and our feelings with each other, I think is a part of trust. Like, I need to be able to feel like I can say what I want to say and not, not that, like, it'll get out or, you know, or people are gonna think badly of it.
And just that, again, whatever we say in here, it's not going to be turned on us once we leave the room, even if we're in different grades. We don't want fourth graders talking about what we talked about in group.
How would it make you feel if someone did share it?
That would hurt. I wouldn't like that very much. I wouldn't do it, so I don't know why other people would.
I don't think I would share anymore if I found out that what I shared got out to the other kids in school.
Right.
I probably wouldn't share again.
That's a great point. What else do you think about trust? Any other thoughts?
I feel like that's been a problem with some of my other friends that I've had before, is that I don't really feel like I can trust them, and that's why we're not very good friends.
That may be why it's harder to find new friends, too, because you have that fear. Okay. Well, that leads me into my next question, Haley. I wanted to ask the group if they can name any situations they've had where they have felt betrayed in trust before.
At school?
At school with your friends that have made it harder kind of to make new friends or maintain those relationships. Does that question make sense? What about you, Nikki? Does that make sense to you? Okay.
I guess something that, like, happened that, like, made me kind of worried was, like, I was in class one day and the teacher asked the question and I raised my hand and I answered it wrong, and one of the girls I thought was my friend, she pointed at me and started laughing and calling me stupid, and the teacher didn't do anything, so I just, like, felt really embarrassed, and I felt betrayed, and then I felt stupid, so I stopped answering questions in class. So, I didn't like it.
You felt betrayed by the teacher?
I felt betrayed by the teacher and my friend, I guess, because I was, like, she always used to, like, we always used to be, like, best friends, so, like, we would talk and, like, do stuff together, and, like, she never called me stupid before, but, like, in front of the whole class, and, like, she knows there's a boy I like in that class, so she said, like, really loudly in front of him, and then, you know, everyone started laughing at me, including her, so... And including him, so, and the teacher just kind of let it slide.
I'm sorry that happened, Nikki, but thank you for sharing, and I definitely feel like that is a time where you definitely felt betrayed, and it could have caused you to not trust people as easily.
I had a similar situation. I went on vacation, so I missed a few days of class, and when I came back, my friends, well, who I thought were my friends, were no longer talking to me, and then another girl in my class said that they were saying stuff behind my back, and then when I asked them, they just completely ignored me, and they won't play with me on recess, so, or sit with me at lunch.
Can you relate to her story?
I can relate to, like, I guess feeling kind of hurt by that, and, like, who you thought you were, like, who you thought were your friends, and now, you know, they're, like, the mean ones.
And you feel like those situations are standing in the way of making new friends. friends or relying on those people now.
It makes me not want to make friends. Yeah, I don't want them to do it too.
Yeah. So making new friends and getting along with people is definitely something you guys want to talk about together in this group. Mm-hmm. Yeah, everybody's nodding their head. So everyone, we can definitely go off of that topic. So today's our first meeting, and I definitely think that we can continue with this topic of making friends. Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I just have, while we're on the topic of trust, I just have like one more question about trust. And so the last question I asked was if you had a specific story about it. What about recently, or maybe if you had to do something today or tomorrow, how do you think you would approach it if you had a hard time making friends? In terms of trust, so how do you feel like you can trust the people around you today and tomorrow, so more recently?
Like, how would we learn to trust them?
No, like, how are you trusting people now?
Oh. I like testing them out, like tell them one thing and see if they tell other people. Mm-hmm. And if they do, then I won't tell them another thing. But if they don't, then maybe I'll try to tell them something else.
Okay.
Or like that's hang out with them more and like feel them out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Maybe start with like small stuff, easy things, mm-hmm. instead of like the big stuff. Mm-hmm. And see how that goes first.
But sometimes they don't know it's a secret. Like if I told then my favorite food was cheese, and they told a friend, like, that was not weird to tell them, so I don't know. Sometimes that's hard.
Yeah. It's hard to use the testing out tool when you're testing it out.
Tell them something, like, super secretive.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That definitely makes sense. Definitely.
Mm-hmm. Also, what if they don't think it should be a secret?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's really weird.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's something to talk about, is what is considered a secret?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think is considered a secret?
Something that I say is a secret. Like, mm-hmm. please don't tell anybody this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Anybody else? What do you do now with trusting?
I feel like I just don't tell them anything.
Mm-hmm.
So that I don't have to think that they have trust. I just don't give them the option.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you feel isolated?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I feel like I can only talk to other kids about school stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Nothing with like big emotions or like stuff like that. I feel like I just like keep those things to myself mm-hmm. now and like anything that could possibly end up in me feeling embarrassed or something mm-hmm. like that in class, I just keep it to myself and, like, I'll write in my diary at home, but I always make sure to leave my diary at home just in case someone else finds it.
Mm-hmm.
It's cool.
Yeah. I saw you nod your head, Haley. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I wouldn't bring my journal to school either.
Mm-hmm. So, were you going to say something?
Well, I was going to say I might tell, like, the big stuff to my mom and dad instead and friends in
mm-hmm.
school because
yeah.
I know that I can trust them.
Good. You know that you can trust your parents.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to bring it back to our group. Instead of thinking about our classmates, I want to bring it back to our group and talk about, again, how this plays into the group. So we don't want to be betrayed. We want to know who we can trust. We want to know if it's a secret or not. So how can we use our knowledge so far on trust in this group?
Should we test out a secret?
Yeah? Do you think so?
Well, we decided that wasn't a good thing to do.
That's right. So we shouldn't test out secrets. But maybe we can express, like you said, hey, I don't want this to be shared.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like say when it's a secret
mm-hmm.
so that everybody knows.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This is something really important. I don't want it to be shared.
Mm-hmm.
I think explaining how we would feel if it got out
mm-hmm.
might help too. Like, I'll be really hurt if this gets out there, or like if you say something about this, like I might actually go cry, or like might make me really sad or upset.
Can you talk about why we think it's a secret, like, or why we don't want other people to know so that they understand how it's gonna affect us if someone tells that?
Good. Well, we're gonna finish group soon, but I just want to go over kind of what we talked about today. We set the expectations of being respectful, being kind, not being judgmental, and not sharing secrets. And I wanted to say thank you for sharing your experiences, and I think that that was very helpful and that it kind of brought us together a little bit more. So as we go on next week, I kind of want you guys to remember what these expectations are and remember what it is to trust people, and maybe something will come up next time about, hey, I want this to be a secret, okay? So I wanted to say thank you to everyone who shared. And then we're going to do one thing before we finish today, and it's called a checkout. And so sometimes when we come to groups, we can do a check-in or a checkout, or maybe we'll do both. So our check-in today kind of looked like, hey, this is my name, I'm in this grade, and I don't know anyone. But next time it may be, hey, how are you doing today? Or how do you feel like you are coming inside the group today? And so a checkout question would be like, how are you doing in group? How do you feel about group? How do you feel about going back to your classroom today? So let's close by going around the circle and answering that question. And that'll be the way we do check-in and check-outs, will be that we'll go around the circle and everyone will be able to share. And so today's checkout question is, how do you feel leaving group and going back to your classroom? Would you like to go first, Ashley?
Yeah. I think I could try trust out with some people in my class, but mm-hmm. also I feel like if I see these girls out in the hallway, I have like a friend now.
Mm-hmm. Somebody to say hey to and feel support. Yeah.
Oh, good. This was fun. Mm-hmm. It wasn't bad. Mm-hmm. I was a little nervous coming because my teacher didn't really tell me much, but now I'm a little bit more excited about next week.
Good.
I'm still a little bit scared just because, like, you know, I'm still working on the whole trust thing, but I think it's cool that I have, like, fifth graders to say hi to now, and I have someone in my class I can talk to sometimes. Mm-hmm. And so I'm excited to see what next week will bring.
Yeah. That's good.
I think I feel the same as everybody else. I feel mm-hmm. good. I didn't really know what we were doing here, uh-huh. like why we were here, but now I feel like I understand better, like what we're gonna be doing in our group. So, and I'm excited to make friends. So,
yeah. I think all of what you said is great, and that this will really be a place to get to know each other and work on this topic together. So before we leave, I just wanted to give you guys an assignment for this week. We're going to meet again next week at the same time, and I'll remind your teachers so they can remind you to come to group. And I want to challenge you to think about some more ways that you trust people, and I want you to think about maybe some more stories that you could bring in about your friends and how you feel betrayed or isolated, or some stories that have worked out well. So just be thinking about those questions this week, and we'll come back together next week at the same time.
Okay. Sounds good.
Good.
Thank you, Miss B.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you for coming.